This is another painting that started out as a little conceptual sketch that I did and really liked. And the problem that I have with little sketches that I like, they always end up not being as good as the sketch. There's just something really nice about simplistic little line art that's done really quickly that I like visually, and then when I try to refine it into something more complete, I find that I actually like it a lot less. And so I procrastinated a lot with this painting. I think I actually gave up halfway through, especially the way that things are right now. I'm not feeling super motivated to actually do much of anything, because as chill as I've gotten in the last week, there's still this like overwhelming hopelessness about it. And I think a lot of it is due to the fact that I relied a lot on the weekly public market to feel like I'm trying, to feel like I'm getting my stuff out there, because online stuff doesn't really work. So it's really hard to like be motivated to do more online stuff. I did finish the painting just because I didn't have anything else to do. But yeah, I forced my way through it. After I did the second layer of crows flying around, if you can't tell that those are supposed to be crows, they are. I don't really get super detailed, especially when I'm doing a sort of cartoon style like this. I thought it was a little bit better, and I was able to push through it a little easier. I think every watercolor painting in particular has that stage where you're just disappointed with how it's going and you tend to quit. I think I wish the birds had a little bit more realistic flair to them, but at the same time, the person doesn't, so it wouldn't really fit, would it? I don't know. So on Patreon this month, we are doing stuff with words in our sketchbooks, whether it's poetry or song lyrics or funny taglines, whatever. Pretty open-ended. If you didn't know, on my website, I do keep a blog maybe once a week at the most. And on there and on Twitter, I did do a flip through of the Flying Cats storybook. It's like a kid's storybook that I had the opportunity to illustrate in 2015. I posted that on Twitter and through Twitter on my blog. I would have done it on YouTube, like as a vlog or as a standalone little extra video, but I don't know if that kind of thing is even allowed on YouTube anymore, because it would definitely fall into children's programming, I think. I don't know. It would have been nice to use YouTube even as like a place to host the video, but I don't think that that's a thing you can do anymore. With the libraries all closed, if anyone wants to look at a new storybook that most people have never seen, you check it out there and just like pause the video to read it. It was a like self-publishing project that was intended to just be seen by children's eyes, which is why I feel pretty confident about being able to reveal the book in such a thorough way. But yeah, you can check it out there. And subscribe to my channel if you want to see more watercolor related videos. And thanks for watching.